Morning, everyone. Welcome here to the Convocation Center. For those that don't know me, I'm Greg Stenner. I'm the Associate Athletic Director for Media Relations here at the University, and we're so proud to have you and welcome you back to campus. It's been a while since you've been here last. A few housekeeping things before we get going today, and then we'll turn it over to President Smith here in just a moment. But remember, if you're in the audience, please turn your cell phone ringer off. We don't want any interruptions as possible. The other thing is, if you're sitting out there, please continue to remember to try to sit at least a couple seats apart, as well as wearing your mask at all times. For media that are in attendance today, we will not take questions here at the podium. We will go in the back, so see one of our media relations representatives at the end of this before we get going for those one-on-ones. For those watching at home, certainly we want to remind media that you can watch the 1 p.m. Zoom link that we've sent out. If not, contact a media relations representative as well for that. Without further delay, I'll turn it over to University President Dr. James M. Smith to get us going. President Smith?
Thank you, sir.
Of course.
Good morning, everyone. I'll lose a mask for a moment here. Thank you for being here. Thank you for joining us. I have a housekeeping job. I am to announce the dignitaries in the audience. And I will do that quickly, and then I will be brief because I realize I am not the key to the show today, nor should I be. So first, for our special guests, I have three of our regents here. Regent Michelle Crum is to the far end of the regents crew here. Michelle is a chair of our athletics committee and also is one of the longest serving regents now. So. Welcome, Michelle, and thank you for being here. Next to her is Regent Alex Simpson. Although looking four decades younger than the president, he is one of our longer serving regents now as well. And Alex is an alum from our social work program, went on to do graduate studies at another place not too far from here, and is also a lawyer and went to law school as well. Chad Newton, who is our newest regent, Chad is a month in, Chad, is that right? 1 month in as joining the Regent group. And Chad is a two-time alum, undergraduate and graduate degree. And we're very glad to have all of you. Ramona Heath is over on this side. Ramona is welcome back home along with Stan. She has an EMU experience, and I'm not gonna tell all those stories, but I'm gonna guess Stan's gonna say a word or two. But we were talking about babies a moment ago, and Ramona said, you know, my baby's playing professional basketball in Belgium. So it tells you that athletics runs in the family for certain. Next to Ramona is Earl Higgins. Many of you know Earl as an alum. If he stood up, you knew that he played basketball here. His height might give that away. And he's also representing Game Above, that many of you know has been a huge contributor to the forward movement here on campus. Next to Earl is Jack Brusewitz. Again, if Jack stood up, you'd know that he was a basketball alum. He is representing Game Above also today. And Jack's actually wearing the Game Above sweater to do some video work later this morning. I also have two vice presidents here. In the middle is Walter Kraft. Many of you know Walter. He is our media and communications vice president. And reluctantly, I got Vicky to sit up front. Vicky Rayum is vice president, works in government relations, and also does tremendous work as secretary to the Board of Regents. Last but not least, we have a foundation representative here up in the front. Some of you know that I have the pleasure of sharing University House with the international relations person in the foundation, Dr. Connie Rule Smith. And as I often say, not my better half, the best half of the people that live in University House. So if you join me in a round of applause for our VIPs, dignitaries, thank you all for being here. I guess I should add one VIP. Swoop's all dressed up today. You're looking shiny over there, Swoop. Swoop informed me in his silence that it's still warm in that suit. So that's not a surprise either. I want to thank those who are with us on video as well as all of you who are here in person. Obviously, this is a big day for athletics. It's a big day on campus anytime we hire a head coach, and we're excited about what our head coaches do for the university in so many ways. I was trying to think of a good story that talks about the impact of our coaches and the duration that some of them have been with us. And Scott Hall came to mind. Many of you know Scott. He's been here 22 years as our head women's soccer coach. And I just had to ask as I was preparing my notes last night, how many young women have been positively impacted by Scott's leadership? How many of his former athletes see EMU in part through his eyes? And if you just think about that, 22 years of involvement. Scott actually was a men's soccer player here before he became head coach. And think about that coaching legacy that goes on. I pick Scott because 22 years is a long run. I don't know, Stan, if you've got 22 years in you, but we're hoping that you do. We've worked through this basketball search in a rather unusual way. We've done a coaching selection process without assistance from outside services. AD Weatherby has taken hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of calls. He's spoken to a number of potential candidates. He's looked at, examined, and interviewed semifinalists and finalists. The pool was incredibly impressive because I believe, and I think all of those who spoke to Scott believe, that this is really a tremendous coaching job. We have a recruiting footprint with Greater Detroit that's second to none. Think about the basketball talent that's come from Greater Detroit and the capacity that we have to make that talent even more and more robust here on this court. I also will add that the second layer has a lot of coverings up there. I'd be happy to take that down maybe next year or the year after and fill it with bodies. And some of you will remember that from the years at Bowen when you were packed into a packed house and the excitement there, and I think we can do that again. I want to conclude by saying a couple things about my time talking to Coach Stan Heath, and I think it's important that you hear what we talked about as a president and as a potential head coach, now as head coach. We talked about recruitment of good athletes, recruitment of good men, and recruitment of men that will walk across the stage and receive that degree 4 or 5 years from the time they join our basketball program. Coach Heath had tremendous answers and tremendous examples in all three of those categories. Now, I will have to say there might have been mention about an NCAA run or two. I don't know. I think I might have heard Regent Simpson ask about Sweet 16, and I might have responded with a Final Four retort. But the three categories that I think were the most important are the three I just mentioned. We know the importance of developing young men into great leaders in the future, and those are the kinds of examples that Stan was able to share. So I will now be quiet, and I will take my seat, and I will introduce to you our athletic director. Many, if not all of you, know him, Scott Weatherby, who is going to sleep, I think, tonight, maybe for the first time in a number of weeks. Scott, the podium's yours.
Thank you.
Thanks, President Smith. We have an awesome president, don't we? I mean, he's great, and appreciate the support, and his best half with her support as well. What a great day. This is just exciting for the university, for our department, for our basketball program. You know, I'm fired up to introduce the coach. I wasn't going to use his name much, but president's already done that, so we'll talk more. But I've got to go through and give some thank yous. So I'll have you bear with me for a minute because I didn't do this alone. This is something that a lot of people are invested and wanted us to get this right, and I think we did. And so I want to say a few thank yous. I want to thank again President Smith for his unwavering support of our athletic department and me and trusting me with the search and actually staying out of it, which is not always easy. And I appreciate the Board of Regents as well. I did want to personally thank Board Chair Eunice Jeffries and our Vice Chair Mike Hawks, who both assisted in the process with me. So I really appreciate their time and effort. Big thank you to Greg Steiner for the setup, his team, all the tireless work behind the scenes, all the graphics getting out. We had placeholders of you know, using the Detroit Pistons head coach as our placeholder, and then we had to change it out and on all of our graphics. And so it's a lot of fun to see them work behind the scenes, but it's a lot of work and to get everything prepared and to get everything set up. So I wanted to say thank you, and they've done a great job. I need to publicly recognize Coach Murphy and thank him for the past 10 years. He left this program in a better place than he found it, and I wish him luck with the Pistons organization. I also want to thank our staff and his staff for dealing with this transition in a first-class manner. Dro and Drew, you guys have put your personal stuff aside to help your own student athletes. And I just really appreciate how you've handled this and through the transition. And I know it takes a lot, so I just want to say thank you for putting them first. So helping me through the hiring process, it was a challenge to try to keep things under wraps. And confidentiality is real important to a lot of these candidates. And so I appreciate my staff doing a good job of kind of keeping this quiet. Through it, I'd like to thank my senior leadership team, Dan McClain, Aaron Keto, Stacy McMullen, and Andy Rowden. They've been great. I want to thank Game Above, and I know Coach mentioned, or President Smith mentioned Earl Higgins. Earl, I really appreciate all your guidance and help during this. And then George Gervin also helped with the process, and to have Iceman walk with you every step, even from afar in San Antonio. He was on all the Zooms with us, and him and Earl have just been phenomenal. And what I am even more excited about is seeing them back on the court around our student athletes and getting Iceman up here and getting a lot of our former student athletes back. Big thank you to Coach Castro and Coach Creighton. Appreciate you both being here, and thanks for being a part of the process and giving me feedback as well. I would have to mention my family real quick, just putting up with all the calls, the texts, the dinner interruptions, the late night shenanigans. There was a lot of it over the last few weeks, even so much that they went to Florida for 2 weeks to get away from it. They went to go and hide. And so now they're ready to be back home. You know, some of those late night shenanigans were talking to Coach Ben Braun. Coach Braun was a great person to just bounce names and ideas and thoughts, and he had no agendas. He just was there to listen, and I really appreciate that. And having that connection back to the winningest coach and the just his wealth of knowledge, really appreciate his help. And he's in California, so we had to set up on Pacific Coast time, and just really appreciate his help. And then I want to thank our basketball student athletes who are here. Thank you for trusting me. This is not an easy process, and the patience. I know you guys wanted to know. You know, every week it's, you know, what's happening? Have you found our coach? And all I know is I wanted to get it right, and I think we did, and we wanted to have a good fit, and I hope you're as excited as we are. 3 weeks ago, I started this journey. It's almost been four now. And in the basketball world and in athletics, this is actually a kind of a slow process, but I think we did it right. I wanted to listen. So I spent the first week, and I met with our basketball team on Wednesday, and then we met again on Friday. And then I had some one-on-ones with them. They reached out to me and wanted to give input and feedback. I met with our donors. We had a great staff call. We met with our basketball alumni. We had 15 to 20 former athletes from the 70s, 80s, 90s, and 2000s, we had them covered across the board. And then I certainly had a number of fans' opinions as well. And, you know, through it all, you know, I wanted to thank our student athletes who took the time. I want to thank the alumni that took the time, and then all those that reached out. It meant a lot, and I tried to get back to everybody as much as possible. But in talking to those different groups, I came up with characteristics of what we were looking for. And it became really clear, and you're gonna, I just thought I'd share with you what we were looking for, or ultimately where I was at in this process. And so our former basketball players in our Zoom meeting was relationships, somebody with character and high integrity, somebody that's connected to Eastern Michigan. embraces the past, want to be connected in Michigan high schools, focused on the student athlete experience, they're the whole player, developer of skills, a teacher, somebody that will promote, I always say relentlessly promote Eastern Michigan, and then somebody that will build a culture. So that was our former student athletes telling me what to look for. So these are a lot of boxes to check. But what I thought was even more interesting is when I talked to our basketball team, this is what they said. They want somebody with experience, somebody that's been there and done that. Coach Heath has been there and done that. And I'll get into some of his numbers. Jokingly, no offense to Coach Murphy, I think they were dead serious. They want to play man-to-man defense. And it's okay to run the zone just occasionally. And run a fast-paced offense. They want to get out into transition, and that's what they talked about. So we talked a lot about that. We connect, you know, they want somebody that's connected, can help them professionally, has those professional connections. Coach Heath has been in the last 4 years a head coach in the G League. A lot of these guys would love to have the opportunity to go to the G League and then to the NBA. So he's seen it. He knows how to develop. And so we talked about that. Culture, identity, and brand. You know, they want a strong culture in their program. They want to be, we want to have a strong basketball presence and brand. And then they talked about relationship driven. They care about your well-being on and off the court. That's something that, you know, when Coach Heath and I met, we talked a lot about putting our arms around these young men and having them grow professionally, whether it's on the court or off the court. And we talked about doing well in the classroom, getting out in our community and giving back, and then obviously doing well in on the court. And then the last thing they talked about was player development. And I think this is an element that Coach Heath can bring that just really stood out to me. And then the type of style that he'll bring. He has an NBA mindset now that he's had a few years with the G League, but he also has the background of recruiting and coaching in college. And some of the things I was looking for when somebody asked early on, I said I'd really like to hire somebody that's been a head coach. And then I'd also really like to hire somebody that played here or went to school here or had a connection to Michigan. And I was able to obviously make that happen. And so when you go through that list, he checks all those boxes. He really fits. And I hope our former players who we talked to said, yes, he got it right. He listened to what we had to say. This wasn't about Scott. This wasn't about the search for him. It was what is the right fit that our student athletes wanted, that our former student athletes wanted, and what was the right fit for the university. And I think we have that person. And so, you know, Coach checks those boxes, and then I realized when we got talking, he has this fire in his belly. You know, that's one of the things you question that somebody's been doing it for a while. But he's got a fire and he's excited to make EMU successful again and getting us back to winning MAC championships and getting to the NCAA tournament. What I also learned is he's a family man. Loves his family, is excited that so many of his family still live here in Michigan, and he gets to come back home and be around them. I got to meet his lovely wife, Ramona, this morning as we're walking through the hall, and I look forward to meeting the rest of his family, including his two sons, Jordan and Joshua. Just real excited for everything that we have going on. And just the last piece, I got to wear my marketing hat for just a second. I want to speak directly to our fans, to our former student athletes. Now's the time to get behind our basketball program. Get behind Coach Heath, and the best way to do that is come around, be visible, but also buy season tickets. Let's help fill up the Convocation Center. The president spoke about let's take off the coverings of the seats and let's start filling into the upper deck. I'm all for it. And we're excited, and I need, you know, we're taking deposits. So I got to put my ticketing hat on. If you're a fan now, let's come on, get on board. And the best way to show Coach that we mean business and we're behind him is to, get in your deposit and get season tickets, and let's welcome him home. So I'm just going to end it with this to introduce Coach and let him talk. This is his day. But here's some last-minute numbers that I just jumped off the charts at me. 30 years of college coaching experience. 13 of those were as a head coach. 17 as an assistant. 4 NCAA tournaments as a head coach at 3 different schools. He's been named Coach of the Year in 2 different leagues. And then he also was named Coach of the Year this past year in the G League. He's been to 3 Final Fours, and he's also won a national title while being an assistant at Michigan State. He played 3 years at Eastern. I'm not allowed to talk about his stats. We're not going to discuss his minutes, points, assists. He said he's good. We can jump past that. And he just finished up, obviously, 4 years with the Orlando Magic in the G League. And when he's done with the G League, he gets to go sit on the bench and be around those NBA guys. And I'm really excited about the style of play that he's going to bring. And I think our players and recruits should be really excited about the type of offense we're going to run and how quickly we're going to play. And so with all that being said, help me welcome home Eastern Michigan's 30th men's head basketball coach, Mr. Stan Heath. So let's do this.
Let's do his jersey.
You're in the middle, coach.
Yeah, we're going to put you in the middle.
There we go.
Now hold it up high.
Yeah,
mother.
Let's just look over your way just a little bit.
There we go.
There we go.
There we go. I'll get my stuff off. We're smiling under our masks, so we'll do more photos in a little bit.
This is awesome. It really is. One thing I knew, if I wasn't the guy standing here, the university with our president and our athletic director is in great hands. And I felt really good about that as well. This is a special day. I mean, it really is. How often do you get a chance to play at a school and come back to the same school and coach? I started here as a Huron. And I'm back as an Eagle. So that's pretty cool in my eyes. My wife, we met here, so that was special. As you mentioned, we have 2 kids, Jordan and Josh, 2 grandkids now too, 4-year-old and a 1-year-old, Zola and Zeke. So this has been a big part of Stan Heath, Eastern Michigan. One of the models I try to follow, and I always tell this to my team, is never forget where you came from. Never forget where you came from, okay? And never forget who helped you get there either. And so I try to live by those models, and this has been a great process. Believe me, Scott did all his homework. He knew things about me I had no idea. And it was great talking to our president, the things he mentioned, because this is more than just basketball. This is about preparing young men for life, preparing them to be successful on and off the court, making sure they know what it takes to make it in this world, because it's not easy. It's not easy at all. So it's more than just basketball. The basketball part's going to take care of itself. We're going to be good. We're going to have great success. You will see that very quickly. It's not going to take a long time. I want to thank a few people as well, too, and I'm going to echo a few people that that Scott mentioned. Our president, James Smith, I thank Scott as well too. Our Regents Jeffries, Regents Hawks, and the board. You guys, all of our conversations, you were grilling me, and I understand why, and I appreciate that. Earl Higgins, Jack, you guys, former players, former greats, I thank you guys as well too. I tell you what, one of the most exciting things that ever happened to me, I got a chance, and you guys are too young to remember this, I got a chance to talk to George the Iceman Gervin. And any of you who are a little bit older, if you went into my garage, there's probably a poster that was the coolest poster ever of George the Iceman Gervin in a Nike suit with 2 ice basketballs next to him. I can't wait to get him down here. I can't wait at all. Doc Sims, he was really important in this as well, too. And this is a little bit off the cuff because I wasn't sure he was going to be here or not, but when I was a freshman at Eastern Michigan, there was a senior on the team who kind of put his arm around me. We used to room on the road, and he took good care of me. He's right here today, and he's a great. Could you please stand up, Fred Cofield? He's a scout for New York Knicks. That's my guy. And so many other players. I had a chance to talk to a lot of the really good players. I've talked to Earl, I've talked to Charles, I've talked to, I haven't talked to Grant yet. I'll talk to Grant. Grant and I were teammates. But so many, and we want you guys back. I want you guys to feel how I feel being back here. And I actually felt a little bit guilty because over the, I don't know, last 20 years, I really haven't been connected to my school here, present here. I always was aware of what's going on. I always kept tabs on the school, but I needed to be more connected here. And this feels good. And I know when the guys come back, they're going to feel the same way. And I want them to feel this way. And I want the players, when you guys leave here, to feel the same way. Like, this is your home, okay? This is where life, a big part of your life, was formed. Coach Creighton, Coach Castro, thank you guys. It's great getting to know you guys and spend a little time with you. I can't tell you this, that you're going to like the way we play. It's a little bit different, but different is good. You don't want to necessarily play like everybody else, okay? We're going to play fast. We call it quick strike offense. At the same time, you know, sometimes you're not going to have the shots you want. We don't want to just, you know, throw it up just to throw it up. We'll go into what we call a flow offense. A flow offense is just one action to another. Flow offense can be pick and roll. It can be drive and kick. It can be post-ups. It can be mismatches, all those different things. Our players will be very well prepared to play, okay? We will know what the other team is doing, and we will exploit the weaknesses they have. We will do that by watching film, by practicing, by talking, all those different things. A team is built, to me, on relationships. The communication you have with your team is extremely important. And sometimes those are hard conversations. They have to be honest conversations, but they can be hard. And one thing I told the players yesterday is nothing will ever be personal. Nothing will ever be personal. If I tell you something, it's how I feel and it's the truth. But you are always welcome to tell me how you feel as well, too. The door goes both ways. And that's how we'll run our program, okay? I also told them that I'm going to treat you like a professional. What does that mean? Okay, it means this. Professionals are responsible. They take care of their business. They go to class. They treat people the right way. They don't do anything to disrespect their family, themselves, or their university. I will hold people accountable when they do that, because I know people make mistakes. I understand that. We do give second chances, but we are here to handle business as well, too. And there's a certain point in time where maybe this is the right place, maybe it isn't. And that's just how we do things. I also want to just kind of leave on this, and because I know you guys have read some things about me. You've listened to our athletic director and our president. I don't want to hold you here all day, but I really appreciate you coming as well, too. This arena needs to be filled. So it's our job, my job, my assistant coach's job, our players, to one, play a style that wins basketball games so they want to come. Secondly, to be involved with the community, okay? Be involved with the community. And thirdly, make sure that the student body, the people who come to this university, the people that work at this university, want to be a part of this experience. I want our players to be a part of the experience at Eastern Michigan. I want Eastern Michigan to be a part of the experience in our basketball Convocation Center. This is not just a one-man job. This takes everybody involved, everybody in this room and people outside this room, to make this thing special. This is a sleeping giant. I was here when Ben Braun took over, okay? The first year, we were just okay. The second year, Ben got things going. It happened quick. The first thing he did was create a culture and environment where guys knew they were here to work and they were here to be successful. Part of that is I like unselfish guys. I like guys that play the right way. I like guys that give multiple efforts out there on the court. And I like guys that aren't afraid to fight and play with toughness and heart. We're going to have that kind of team here. We will have that type of team here. And people will like watching teams that play that way. Again, I'm super excited to be here. My door is always open for our former players. If you guys want to come by and watch practice, you want to come in the locker room, you want to talk to our players, this is your program. You are welcome. We also need your help. Again, thank you guys for coming out today. I really appreciate you. I look forward to building relationships across our campus with everybody here. Thank you.
You want to get some photos? Okay. All right, we'll get some photos and we'll do it.
We'll just say that's it, but thank you for coming out. Appreciate all the support. We're